Once we've collected all of our point locations and recorded the information on each of our point locations that we've looked at on our study area, we have three options to look at that data. The first option is up here, and you can see we can click on Report, and what Report do will provide us with a live view of our data that we've collected. And in this case here, we're reporting in by percent cover. You can see that up top here. And we have each of our categories. So in this case, H is grass and herbaceous material, 22%. 26% is tree and shrub. 14% is impervious buildings. And you can see that is graphically illustrated up top, and down below it's in a tabular form. So you're able to look at that. The other thing you can do is report by area, where it looks at the square miles of each of our cover classes. So we have the choice of going for the square miles reporting by area or reporting by our percent cover. And each of these reports, all you simply want to do is to be able to save them. All you do is go to print, and you're able to save them as a PDF file or print them out as a paper form right on your printer. But the idea is to save them generally in PDF form, so you have those as a record, and you can import those into other documents and utilize those as your archive. The second thing we can do when we're in iTree Canopy is export our data, once we've completed everything, into an Excel spreadsheet. So what we can do up top here, we simply click on the export button, and what it does, it brings up a dialog box, and in this case here, it shows that we're going to save the data as a CSV, or a common delineated file, for viewing in Excel. And in this case, this project is Hartford, Connecticut. So we would type in the name of the project that we're working on and save it as a CSV file, and simply go ahead and click OK, and it puts it in our downloads folder where we can open it in Excel. The last component, and probably the most important, is down below where we save our data. And you can save your data throughout the process of collecting your points, so you don't lose any of your work through the process. But when we click on our Save the Data, what we come up here now is the dialog box that allows us to save a file in a DAT or a data format. What then that allows us to do is to save the data on our computer so that we can archive it, we can file it away, or we can import it back into iTree Canopy at any later date, so that we can review the work we've done, or demonstrate iTree Canopy findings to other people, or simply print new reports. So the idea is you type in the name of your town followed by the DAT extension, simply hit OK, and what that does, it also brings it over to your downloads folder where you can open that and import it back into iTree Canopy. So those are the three components. We have the report button up top here, where we're able to look at the report in tabular and graphic format. We're able to export our data. We're able to export it into an Excel spreadsheet formatting. And then most importantly, and probably most useful, would be to save our data so that we're able to archive our files and re-examine those at a later date. So that ends the demonstration here of the export and reporting features for iTree Canopy.